comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. Fixing and fixing and all his reindeers pulling on the reins.
Hey, what's up, you guys? It's your boy, Griffy, and welcome back to my channel. Hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. Leave a like on the video. Hit the notification bell so you get notified every time I upload. It's Vlogmas 2019. We are here. It is the Christmas season, the holiday season. I am excited. I hope you guys are excited. It's time for Christmas, New Year's, wonderful time, you know, and it's a feel-good time. So I want to thank you guys, all of my subscribers. If you're new to the channel, welcome. Thank you for being a part of this. You're in for a wild ride. I know I haven't uploaded in months, but that's okay because, you know, I'm here now and I wanted to post some content before the end of the year because I don't want people to say, hey, you haven't posted since last year. And it's just like, I know. Life, been busy. You know how that goes. I'm going to try to be more consistent in 2020. That's number one, a huge goal of mine. Even if it's something menial or something small, like a short clip or something, I'm going to post. I'm going to make sure of that. And I'm going to try to start posting every day. And so even if I forget for like a couple days, it might be because I'm like super, super busy or I'm like sick. And even if I'm sick, I'll try to put something out. So I want to first off by saying for day one, this is pre-recorded, of course. But, you know, I just want to give a quick little shout out to all of my friends. This video is mainly about shout outs and, you know, everybody that I want to thank, even because we just got through Thanksgiving and it seems like, you know, Thanksgiving was just a couple days ago. So I want to do this video leading into Vlogmas because it is a time for happiness. And I want to give a shout out to, before I forget, my good friend Kayla K-Season. I will drop her channel in the description below. She doesn't post, but go send her some love. My best friends, Sean, Michaela, Ben, you know, you guys know who you are. My team of people that I've been surrounded by for the past couple of years, thank you. You know, we have our struggles. I don't need to say more on that, but we're still here. At the end of the day, we got each other's backs, and I appreciate y'all. Thank you, because I've had my days when I've been broken down, but you picked me right back up. And yeah, so just a quick little, this is kind of like a rambling video, just because I don't know what to say, and I don't have anything planned fully, but I will by the end of the week. The first couple videos might seem a little unorganized, and that's okay. But starting next year, I actually hope to get a camera for myself, and like a backdrop that I can like put like right here. So even if I have like my camera sitting like right here, like where my laptop is right now, where I'm filming, I want to put my camera right there in that spot because it is a really good spot. And then have like a sheet like right here behind me. I don't know if you guys can see, but like a sheet like that kind of covers this. And I've seen pop up like green screens or whatever that I want to work on. And I want to get like a lavalier mic and all that stuff. And a lot of that stuff is going to come towards next year. And hopefully by the summer, I'll have a full recording setup for specific type of videos. But, you know, actually, because I actually want to do reaction videos kind of standing up so I can like, you know, look at the video. I'll figure out a way to do that. But it is what it is. You know, it's just gonna be like, oh wow, that's crazy. Like, you know, like look at this guy, right? Cause like I'm thinking if I have my camera set up here and then don't worry y'all. Like I said, this is a rambling video and I'm just thinking out loud, and this is that video where you see me thinking about organizing my setup of how I want things to be. And this could be a future setup. This could be a setup in the future. It doesn't have to be right now, but I'm just keeping this in mind and putting this out on paper. And even if you guys want to try this setup, you know, I'm giving you the idea, you know, kind of like newscaster. Like there are some channels where people are standing off to the side and they have the videos. You know, so, you know, the beat down with Willem, you know, she does her videos like this. So it's very similar to that. But like I said, we will have a screen so you don't see any of this ugly, to hide all of this. But, you know, yeah. So I'm just gonna slide back into the center of the frame. Yeah. So I think one of the things that I think that people need to remember, if you want to start a YouTube channel, have fun, be yourself. If you ever wanted to know if you should do it, do it. I created a channel just because I wanted to watch people play video games. And I've been doing, I did that for a couple years before I decided, hey, I have a channel, I want to make videos, I want to post, I want to be like these guys. And so I started posting videos that weren't of me for a long time. And then I was like, you know what? I feel like I'm old enough. I'm going to post videos of me. I'm going to express myself and give my talent to the world. And, you know, it's happened. I've recorded so many videos of me playing that I have not uploaded. And I've deleted footage because it's just, it just wasn't at the quality that I wanted it to be for uploading purposes. And yes, y'all, I'm short. Like, I'm taking off my Crocs, and I'm basically, like, the same height. But, you know, that doesn't matter, because I fit in the frame, and that's all that matters. Like, I have a little bit of room to the top of the frame. So, you know, that's what's up. But, you know, But, yeah, like, one big tip is if you want to be successful, just be yourself. And, you know, just be confident. And people will start to accept you. And, you know, hey, it's okay to make a fool of yourself. I had to learn that the hard way of, like, you know, hey, you don't have to take it so seriously all the time. You can, you know, you can make fun of yourself. It's okay. Self-deprecation. It's like, especially when you're confident and, like, you know, you're at a certain level to where it's like, yeah, no, I can say I'm bad. But people will be like, no, you're fine. You're fine. Like, I don't think... Like, the only time I knew last weekend when I did my, when I did the show on my birthday, I knew that I killed it. I knew I did. Because I could feel the energy. And it was a weird energy going in, but I had my head. And let me tell y'all, story time. Quick story time. So, I had walked in. I had got there super early. And I was just like, all right, I'm here early. Like I said, I wanted to be great. Everything is going great so far. Starting with being on time. That's beautiful. I'm here before downbeat. And, you know, I was just like, wow, it's my birthday. We got the show to do. We got to perform for these people. We got to, like, turn it up, turn it out. I was like, look, I'm here for a good time. Like, you know, we've been rehearsing this music all semester. And... you know, it is what it is. I didn't think when in rehearsal, I didn't think that my solos were going to be number one. I didn't think I was gonna have that many solos. I had, of the 9 songs that we played, I had like 4, maybe 5 solos, and quite a few of the songs I had to give cutoffs for because our director played drums on quite a few tracks, and some of the tracks that he wasn't playing on, he wasn't giving cutoffs. And so me being first chair, I had to pay attention and keep my eyes open and be aware. Situational awareness is a great thing to have when you're a section leader, because you have to know when to direct people, when to cut them off, because that is very important. Cutoffs are very important in band all the time. It doesn't matter whose group you're in. If you know how to cut off properly, you're good. That is what separates a good band from a great band, is a cutoff. There are many other things that also separate a good band from a great band, but knowing how to cut off, you know, attack, sustain, and release. That's it. And so a lot of the principles that I've learned over the years, and even from the past couple directors that I've had, all of their techniques and their foundations and their lessons that they've given me on how to be a better player, I've taken that into this group and applied it appropriately, and it worked wonders. One thing If you look at my music, you will see I have chicken scratch written all over it. Because, especially in jazz, because it's like, I'm writing notes, like in rehearsal, our director will be like, okay, saxes, I need you to back off here. And then I'll be like, all right, so I'll literally write back off at the part, and I'll circle the notes, and I'll like draw an arrow, and I will literally write like air, 1, 2, 3 tempo time and key. I'll circle key signature, I'll circle key changes, I'll circle all of that. And so, yeah, and it gets like that. but, you know, getting back to concert night, the night of the show, so I said I got there early, which is what I wanted to do, which was great. After that, I just remember, like, everything was a blur. Like, I had got there early, I had warmed up, and it was electrifying. We had ran through, we had did a quick run through of some of the songs. And I was like, okay, we're doing this. And you know, concert days for me, they always feel weird. Cause it's like, you know, it's a concert and you don't think much of it, but you know, hey. So I was like, all right, I don't have stage fright because I've done this multiple times. I've performed in much larger crowds, but I think smaller crowds, like more intimate settings, scare me more than a larger crowd, than large venues, because at least with a large venue, like, yes, there's lots of people watching you and there are a lot of eyes on you, but in a small intimate setting, you're even closer. And so where we were really close to the crowd. And so I was just like, well, if I mess up, they're going to hear me. So I cannot mess up. And I tell you, I missed maybe like one or two notes the entire concert. I played out of tune like once or twice. I can't remember. I don't think I did. I don't think I missed a single note. I may have missed a couple notes here and there in a song or two or three. But honestly, I haven't listened to the full recording, but I need to go back and listen because I will be, and I will share the audio on my channel. I will put the audio up. So I just remember the concert going by so fast. Like, we're in the dressing room upstairs while the people are filing in, while the crowd is coming in, and we're upstairs, we're tuning, we're just chilling. And you know, for me, that's my happy place. My happy place is my pre-show routine. I'm in the zone. I'm just like, you know, we doing this. This is show night. We got this. We've been working on this all semester. We got this. Ain't no need to worry. I know my parts. I've been practicing. Not really. I don't really practice my parts because I learn it. And then, you know, I learn it. I learn my music while I'm in rehearsal. And it's just like fine-tuning things. Like sometimes I rehearse, but this semester I didn't really have to rehearse anything, but last year I did, and you know, I ended up memorizing a piece, but I forgot how to play it because I stopped playing it, and so that killed me a little bit, because I really wanted to keep playing it from memory, but I gotta go back and relearn it because of the key signature. That's the only thing. Key signatures are what get me with learning music, but you know, so we tune, and I'm the first one to tune, and he's like, concert A, he's like, player B, and I'm like, all right, so I'm like, ah. And it's like, I was sharp, so I had to pull out, so I pulled out a little bit, pulled my mouthpiece out a little bit, played again, ah. In tune, you know, I was like, okay, we're doing this, this is happening, so we go through, we tune everybody, then we get up. We, some of us hop in the elevator. Some of us take the stairs. I was in the elevator and I was like, I'm not walking down the stairs with this instrument because if I do, I don't want to trip and fall. So I'm just going to take the elevator, you know, just because, you know, but I was excited because I was like, I just hope my reed doesn't get dry and that I start the concert off really, really bad. Cause once your reed is dry, it usually takes you quite a bit before you're actually sounding like you're supposed to. And my skin is looking really good, even though, like, I've been using a Tahitian vanilla coconut oil body scrub, and it is wonderful. It is so wonderful. It makes your skin so, so soft and so smooth, and I love it. I use it on my hands, legs, feet, arms, my face, my neck, my beard line. Yeah, I got a beard growing in. You guys can't see that, but yeah, there's hair here. There's hair growing. And so I have to keep that moisturized. Like, you should always keep your face moisturized, but I have to keep it extra moisturized because, you know, I want my beard to be thick and full and healthy like the hair on my head. And also, I'm going to be cutting this off pretty soon. I'm cutting it right before Christmas because, you know, I just can't deal. And also, I need to, I'm growing my afro back out by the end of 2020 so that when I turn 21, I can either get my twists or my faux locks or whatever I decide to do. I can get it then because my hair will definitely be long enough. Because at that point, I will have been growing it for almost a year, and my hair grows really fast. So even at this length, it'll be at this length in like a few months. So it wouldn't take long. So yeah. But yeah, because I look at my old pictures and I'm just like, wow, I had such a lot of hair. Like, I miss my afro so much and I want it back. And so now I'm at a place where I'm just trying to get it back. But anyways, we start the show and it's just, I'm like, all right, I got to give cut off. So I'm like, I got to give cut off for the first song. And I got a solo. So I was just like, I was feeling really good. I was like, it's my birthday. I get to do a solo. And I'm playing written solos on these pages because I'm just like, this music is here for a reason. I'm going to play it. I'm going to redeem myself from not playing written solos at all while I was in high school. And because I worked on them and because I practiced them, I was rewarded with the satisfaction that I gave a good performance and I played them with conviction. And because it was the acoustics in the room, I was able to hear myself very clearly. And when it was my solo, it was my solo. I don't care. I was playing over everybody. I was like, look, this is my solo. I'm about to shine. We doing this. And I sounded great. And listening to my first solo, I was like, I did that. You know what I'm saying? I did that. So I'm excited to go back and listen to my other solos and see how I sounded. And also, I like to listen to concerts afterwards just to critique myself. And because I can hear myself really, really well in the recording. Considering that our piano player recorded it, he's amazing for doing so and sending it to us. So I'm just gonna go in FL Studio, chop it up by song, and burn some copies of CDs for it, just in case, and give it out to my family, whoever wants it. So yeah, that's it. And I'm probably gonna Photoshop a little picture for the group. But yeah, so I think that the concert went well overall. I'm happy with how it turned out. We had a great crowd. We almost had a full house. And that was satisfying to see. So you know, it was great to see. And I was just like, you know what? I like that. I like to see that. So it was great that all those people came out. And even though the crowd was mostly older people, because that's the crowd that grew up on jazz and really appreciates the art of jazz, you know. So getting to play for them, and then after the show they came down and they were talking to us and they were like, you guys sounded great. And then I got quite a few personal compliments of like, you sounded really good, and we could hear you really well, and you were just amazing, and the songs were really good, and you guys, like, you did it. Like, you did the thing. And so that put a smile on my face, because having such rave reviews on a performance, it makes you feel good. As a performer, as an entertainer, you perform for yourself, but for the crowd. And if the crowd loves it, then that's it. And so that's why I'm a performer. I like being on stage, and I like performing, and I like entertaining people. I know how to entertain people with what I have. Whether I have my instrument or not, I can entertain a crowd. And so that's a skill that I'm lucky to have. I feel blessed to have. And so I know I'm rambling, and I'm going to stop this before a quick time tries to freeze on me again because I tried recording another video that was completely different. I said a whole lot of different stuff. Something completely different from this, but I want to make sure that I get the recording in before, you know, I get frozen on this laptop. So I want to thank you guys for watching. Again, hit the subscribe button, like button, bell button to get notified. And, you know, I'm excited for Vlogmas. Let's turn up. Oh, and one more thing before I forget. Before I leave you guys. So for the 12 days of Christmas, I'm going to be doing a 12 days of Christmas music challenge. So I'm going to be playing like 12 different Christmas songs on my instruments, saxophone, clarinet. I don't know about flute. I don't think I'm going to do flute yet. That might come next year. We'll see where I'm at with my skills next year. And, you know, we'll have that. So don't be surprised if you see a stand like over here while I'm like playing. And like, if you see a stand, you know, like you probably won't see it because it'll be out of frame. But just know that one, I'm going to tell you up front, I'm probably going to use sheet music. Two, I'm not going to memorize, you know, 12 Christmas songs by the 13th in like 2 weeks. That's absolutely ridiculous. So, you know, just be on the lookout for that. And I will catch you guys tomorrow. We out.